Hello everyone, welcome to the next part of the Scoreboard System Blueprint tutorial. And if you haven't watched the first part of this tutorial series, I would suggest you to go watch that. And for this part of the tutorial, I'm going to go over how you can set up the user interface. So without further ado, let's head into the widgets folder that I have created. To create the user interface, let's click on right-click in the counter browser and then go to user interface right here. And then we look down here, there's a widget blueprint. So let's click on that. And all we need is a user widget, or you can click on that, or you can select that as well. And select. For this widget, I'm going to call this widget home score, like that. And let's go ahead and click into the widget home score. Once the widget blueprint is open, you will see this window right here. And within this blueprint, there's a designer tab and a graph tab. The graph tab is pretty much just an event graph where you can put in all the codes that you make for this specific widget. And the designer tab is where you can design your own user interface with all the things at the pilot tab right here. And to start out, we will need a canvas for this widget. So let's head over to the search over here and search for a canvas. And add in the canvas panel so we can add in things into the UI. And you can see that there's a little error over here as well. This is for if you want to increase your resolution for your UI, which basically most of the time I would do 1080 HD right here, like so. And then since in my example, I kept the user interface as simple as possible. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to add a text and a button press for this user interface. So let's cancel that. Next, I'm going to drag a text into the user interface. So in the comments tab here, search for text and then drag this into the user interface. And we'll see a text block. And to change the text block into a different text, let's go to the details panel to the right, and then at the text section, we can change the text into something else. So since this is a home score user interface, I'm going to change the text into the home team scores, something like that. And you can see that the text has updated. And to increase the size of the text, we can go to the size over here and then scale this up. And I'm going to make this into 100. And I also increase the screen bar as well. So, and then position this into somewhere in the center of the screen and increase that again. And in terms of alignment, I'm going to order justification in here. I'm going to do it as a center, so it'll align to the text. It'll align to the center of this green box right here. Next, I'm going to change the anchor point. Right now, the anchor point is at the top left corner of the screen. So what anchor does is pretty much it'll make a when as the screen resolution changes, it will keep the text or whatever. Or whatever asset you're using into this corner right here. So let's say I'm putting this home team score like here, and I want this to remain this way as the screen changes size. It will automatically anchor the text into this corner. So if I want this side, if I want to anchor this side, then it will try to keep the distance the same from this anchor point. So just keep in mind when you do this, make sure the anchor point's at the place where you want. So for me, I'm just going to make this centered. The anchor point is centered onto the screen. And I'm going to center this into somewhere over here, like so. Now, next step is to create a button. So back in the palette tab, we can look for a button right here. And let's drag that into the user interface. To scale the button, just simply scale this up by dragging one of the corners of the button. And probably this size will work. And I'm going to position it over here and the anchor as well. I'm going to change the anchor into the centered. And you can play around with the color of the button and use different styles for like hovering when you hover over a button. And I won't be going over that. You guys can go ahead and play around with it by yourself. Now to add a text onto the button, all we need to do is to drag the text into the button that we have on the user interface. So now that we have the text block over here, we can change the text as well. So for this, since it's not game over yet, I'm just gonna say next round. And then I can also increase the size of the text. And I'll probably change the color of the text as well, so it's clear. You can see this more clearly, like so. I'll just change it to black. And that is pretty much the screen for scoring and for game over as well. So what happens when we click on a next round button? Well, in terms of the logic for this game, when you click on next round, it should restart the match. So how do we set that up? If we click on the button right here and then we scroll down the details panel, we can see that there is a list of events we can do. And in the on-pressed event, I'm going to create something on the on-pressed event. So if we click on that, it will take us to our event graph for this user interface. Since we want to restart the match, we can simply use a open level to restart right here and then put that in. All we need to do is have the level name the exact same as the level that we are using. So in this instance, I am using just the main level right here. So back into our widget blueprint, let's just name this as main. And then we can compile and save. And that's pretty much the setup for the user interface. Go ahead and set up the UIs for the away score and for the game over as well. Once you have all the user interface created, like over here, I have the away and the game over created. And it's basically just the same thing as a home score. I just changed the word into away team over here. And for the game over, I just pretty much put a game over and then changed the word into restart over here. So next thing is we need to add this into our game, because if we play this game right now, the UI won't come out because we haven't told the Unreal Engine when to exactly to have the UI prompt up. So back into our scoreboard tutorial blueprint. We will need to have the user interface for the home score at the home collision over here and away score at the away collision. And for the game over, it will be on this game over branch over here, wherein the minutes is equal to zero. And then when there's no more seconds as well, if it's true, then it will go to game over. So let's set that up. To show a UI in the game, we will need a create widget node. So from the home collision over here, home goal collision that I have, I'm just gonna drag this out and then search for a create widget. So you can create the widget that you have just made. And for the class, I'm gonna choose the home score widget over here and then have this added to the viewport like so, and then plug that in. So then it will show when the ball has overlapped the home goal. And we'll do the same for the away score as well. So I can just pretty much copy and paste that and then link that up and then change this into the away score over here. And then same thing as game over, I'm just gonna leave the print screen over here. And then same thing, I'm just gonna paste the widget, connect that, and then change that into the game over widget over here. So now we can compile and save. And then we test that out and move the ball. You can see that the UI will prompt up. And then when it turns to zero, then the UI of game over will also come out too. So there's that. And if I press restart, it will restart. And if I do this and then press next round, it will restart as well. But you can see that everything resets. That's because we haven't made a save slot for it as well. Another problem you might encounter is that if you play the game without doing the simulate mode, just the normal play game, You will see that if you score, just for example like this, there is no mouse cursor for you to actually press any button for the game. So how do we enable the mouse cursor to appear? Well, it's actually pretty simple. All you need to do is first at the back in the scoreboard tutorial blueprint, I'm going to search for a get controller, a get player controller right here. And then within this get player controller from the return value, I'm going to search for a show mouse cursor. And we're going to set the show mouse cursor into true and then link that up. And then I'm going to copy and paste that for the away score as well and link that up as well. And then plug in the return value of the player controller into the target here. And then we will also do the same for the game over as well. So over here, I'm going to copy and paste and then link that up as well. So when this is done, we can go back to our scoreboard blueprint. And I'm going to change this into actually 20 seconds so I can give myself more time for myself. And if we play this now, you can see that our mouse cursor appear. And if I press next round, it will restart the whole level like so. So that's that's a way to enable the mouse cursor to appear on your screen. And I'm going to test out for the game over as well. So for the game over, if I press restart over here, you can see that the level restarted as well. So it works. The next problem we want to solve is to stop the timer when there's a goal. So if I start the game right now and then have the ball go into a goal, you can see that the timer is still going on. So we want a way to stop it. And to do this, it's actually pretty simple as well. We just need a Boolean variable to check if the point is scored. So back in our scoreboard tutorial, in our variables, I'm going to add a new variable and then call this point scored. And I'm not going to make this instance editable because we don't need to have this shown in the editor. And what we want to do is before the delay in the event tick, I mean after the delay actually in the event tick, we're going to use a branch again, another branch. And then we're going to link that up to the delay over here. And the condition for this point score, we're going to get point scored. And then put this in the condition is that if the point is not scored, then it will do all these minutes countdown, a seconds countdown logic over here. So that's false. And if it's true, then we will do nothing. So then the time will be stopped right there. And at the overlap collisions over here for the home and away, we will need to add in the point scored into true. So let's get the point score. And then I'm going to move these out a bit more so I can have more space for the set point scored. So we'll link that up together. And then if the point score, if the goal goes into the home score, of course the point is scored, right? So we need to have this point score to true. And then same as for the away as well. So let's just copy and paste that and then put it in the away section over here. And that's pretty much it to solve that specific problem. So if we play the game again and then push the ball into the home score, into the home goal, we can see that the timing has stopped. And we do that the same thing for the away. You can also see that the time has stopped as well. So that's a way to combat this issue. And that'll be all for this tutorial. And I don't want the videos to go for too long, so I'll talk about the save slots in the next tutorial, so look forward to that. Thank you for watching, and I hope you guys have a great day. And as always, never stop learning.